Hello guys, Neapple Times here, welcome to a new video, and Apple has just released visionOS 1.1 for the Apple Vision Pro. Okay, so a little over a month after the release of the Apple Vision Pro, we finally have the first kind of major-ish update. Of course, visionOS 2.0 is expected to be announced in June at WWDC and released probably in September or October, but we now have visionOS 1.1. And I installed the release candidate a few hours ago, and I must say, the difference is night and day. So in this video, we're going to go through every new feature in visionOS 1.1. Okay, so the first change you will see after first putting on Apple Vision Pro after the update is that personas have been updated and improved. So all the persona experience has been improved in general. When you first put it on, as I said, you will be prompted to set up your persona again, just like you did the first time. And I noticed that after you do all the movements and everything, it actually takes a little longer than before to process the persona. According to Apple, what they have improved is the hair and makeup representation, and the capture of the mouth and the neck. Also, when you're going to set up your persona now, you do have the option to do it hands-free. Also, and because it depends on the persona, eyesight has also now been improved. But I let you be the judge.
This was my persona before the update, and this is my persona after the update. Do you think it has improved? Let me know in the comments below.
But yeah, in spite of all these changes, the persona still appears as a beta. Next super big thing I want to talk about, and this actually gets me the most excited, is that they have improved reliability on the Mac Virtual Display feature. Okay, what I just read you is actually what Apple just included in the release notes. However, this is actually a night and day difference. To me, the Mac Virtual Display feature went from actually unusable to absolutely great. This was a bummer for me because that was one of the things I was more excited about the Vision Pro, and it was working horribly bad. Like, I blamed my router, I even changed the router, I bought a new one, I changed everything, but it continued working really, really poorly. To the point that it was actually unusable, especially for something like editing video, Final Cut, or something like that. There was a lot of lag, the keyboard and the mouse were super laggy. That was actually one of the reasons why I didn't use my Vision Pro that much. However, after installing the update, I went to try it, and it works almost flawlessly now. Like, I'm not kidding, the difference is that good. I can even edit video in Final Cut on that, and that's a lot to say. But yeah, especially the mouse moves almost instantly in the Vision Pro screen, and that was of course trying it with the same Wi-Fi that I did before. So yeah, this gets me super excited, and I can't wait to use it more in the future. Next up, we have a few minor changes, such as updated splash screens in Photos and TV app, and Apple added support for iMessage contact key verification. This is of course a security feature that was added to iOS 17.2 on the iPhone, but it's now coming to Vision Pro. Also, a little but annoying thing that they fixed is that now you can see the notification numbers on top of the compatibles folder. Now you can see how it was before, that I had notifications here but they weren't showing on the screen, whereas now they will show in the compatibles folder. Now you can see how it was before, where I had notifications here but they wouldn't show in the main screen, compared to now, where they actually show in the compatibles folder. Also, most of Apple's system apps have been removed. Now, you can't really tell in this video, but I'm trying to pinch and hold to delete them, and they don't do anything. And now you can see that they actually give me the option to delete them. Now, there is also a small bug fix for the keyboard, and is that the cursor positioning when pinching has been improved, and that actually makes also a huge difference, because I found I had a lot of issues before doing exactly that. Also, something that I didn't see Apple mention but I noticed is that the eye tracking has been improved, especially on iPad compatible apps. And then a few other super minor changes is that content can now be positioned closer, which I didn't really notice a difference on, but if Apple says it, must be true. I did find, however, that the in-screen keyboard is actually more comfortable to use, especially when you type like this, because before you had to like go through the keys, and now it's actually way simpler and it works more like actually typing on a tablet or something. Then Apple has added mobile device management support, which enables device configuration, deployment, and management for enterprises. And finally, Apple says that they have added captive network support. Now, this was a big issue with me because I first set up my Vision Pro in a hotel, and the Wi-Fi in that hotel was actually a captive network. So I have to share my data from my phone in order to be able to activate Vision Pro. Lastly, I want to say something that I did actually encounter. I've been mentioning it in previous videos and even on Twitter. Less than 24 hours after getting my Vision Pro, I had to go to the Apple Store because I was seeing everything blurry, so whenever I didn't look to the dead center, I looked a bit up or down or to the sides, it would appear blurry. And yeah, we were there for almost 4 hours trying to isolate the problem, trying to see what happened, try to see the issue, try to fix it. And I did find that actually works better in visionOS 1.1. So has Apple fixed the issue because of my input and my advice? We will never know, but I actually did genuinely find it better. But yeah, this is everything new in visionOS 1.1. It is actually exciting to see Vision Pros evolve step by step, such as introducing some key features that were missing from the first release version, such as mobile device management or captive Wi-Fi support. They are really, really tiny features that they're just good to have, and that will of course make visionOS a more robust system over time. But yeah, we should probably see visionOS 1.2 beta coming soon, and of course, we can't wait to see visionOS 2.0 be announced at WWDC in early June. So if you don't want to miss any of that, or for that matter, any other Apple news or products or unboxings or anything, you should subscribe to this channel, because that's exactly what I post. But yeah, thank you very much for watching, and see you in the next one. Bye.